Yes, I'm here to, we're going to have a sermon tonight, and it's going to be, Jesus died for you so you can be saved. But there's one little thing that I would like to mention tonight also is, he allowed you to be able to have a relationship with God. He's enabled you to be able to have a relationship with his Father. Jesus Christ, God, and the Holy Spirit, all are three, all are one. God, the Father, and the Holy Spirit, God, and the Son are one. When Jesus Christ died on that cross, he died on the cross and shed his blood, that you are able to be saved. You're able to go to Jesus and say, I want you in my life. I want you to be my Lord and Savior. And that enabled you to be able to have a relationship with God the Father. And also, I'll be mentioning about how when Jesus Christ was crucified on the cross, how the curtain of God, how the curtain was torn down, and I'll be mentioning about that. So I'm going to quickly pray for one sec, and then we're going to get into the Word of God. And I'll just start to pray now. Lord Jesus, just allow your Word tonight to touch people. Allow the Word of God to talk to people, Lord Jesus. Allow the Word of God and what you want to put on their burdens, on their hearts, Lord. Allow this message, the message from God, the message from the Word of God, to burden people's hearts and to burden people's hearts and burden their deepest wants, Lord, that the Holy Spirit will burden them and will give them a message from you, Lord, a message from the Word of God, a message from God that they need to be hearing, Lord. Lord, allow this Holy Spirit to be throughout this message, throughout this place, Lord, and allow the Holy Spirit to come down on this church tonight, Lord, to burden people's hearts that there is an urgency that we have a relationship with Jesus Christ, and that Jesus Christ is Lord of Lords, and they need to realize, Lord, that you will put a burden on their heart and touch their heart tonight. Thank you, Jesus. Now, before we get into the sermon tonight, as I said, Jesus died for you so you can be saved. He allowed that when he went was on the cross and he said it was finished, that this was earth, that the earth moved and this curtain in the temple was fallen away aside. So I'm going to get into this a little bit more, and I'm going to now play a song quickly. And this song I'm going to play is He Will Be Handed Over to the Gentiles. They will mock him, insult him, spit on him, flog him, kill him, and on the third day he will rise again. Luke 18:32-33. You know, this is what the Bible, this is what the Word of God was saying. He'll be handed over to the Gentiles. I'm talking about Jesus here. They will mock him, insult him, spit on him, flog him, and kill him. And on the third day he will rise again. Which, when I go into the scripture a little bit more tonight, you will actually know a little bit more of what this is saying. So we're going to listen to this song, and that was from Luke 18:32-33. He will be handed over to the Gentiles. He will be handed, the person that's going to be handed over to the Gentiles is Jesus Christ. They will mock him, insult him, spit on him, flog him, kill him, and on the third day he will rise again. And by him rising again, and by him allowing to be crucified, you are able to come to Jesus and say, I want a relationship with Jesus. I want a relationship with God, and I want Jesus Christ in my life. That is the reason Jesus Christ died on the cross, so your sins can be forgiven and you can be saved. So I'm going to play this song now. So everyone, just listen to that, and then we'll get into the Word of God.
Thank you for the price you paid, bearing all my sin and shame. In love you gave amazing grace. Thank you for the love, Lord. Thank you for the nail of me. Watch me in your cleansing come. Now all I know, you're for me.
Worthy is the Lamb. Jesus Christ was the Lamb. Jesus Christ was a Lamb to the point that he was led off to be slaughtered by the Gentiles. But there's a message in this that this was what Jesus had to do. And as Jesus says, that in Matthew 1, as I've said before, is in Joseph's dream. Joseph was told by an archangel that you will take Mary, and Mary will have this baby, and Joseph, you will name this baby called Jesus, and this baby will save people from their sins. I'm going to go to part two of the message. Jesus died for you so you can be saved, and he also teared down the curtain to allow us into God's holy place. I will go on to part two in a couple of seconds, and I will continue on to part two of this message.